LA County, it is starting to move out, and you can see we have a live view of the Doppler here. We could see one more little swath make its way through, but this might dissipate before it actually gets into LA County. So there's one last thank you. There's one last possibility of a little bit of rain right here moving. It's moving through Santa Barbara at the moment. Here's Ventura and here's LA County. You can see that the bulk of it now is in Orange County, and it's actually starting to make its way through San Bernardino, Riverside, and of course, the snow. Look at that. We are going to see a decent amount of snow. Not too bad, because of course this is a weak system and it's moving through very fast. But as we go ahead and put the microcast in play, you can see that by tomorrow afternoon at 6 p.m., look at that. Nothing but clear skies. It is going to move through very quickly. By tomorrow morning, we could see maybe a lingering shower or two along the foothills, but that's really about it. Most of us are going to be clear and dry. All right, let's take a look at the overnight lows. Going to be chilly tonight, 39 and Ojai, bundle up. We're looking at most areas in the low 40s and low 50s. 49 for Hollywood, a little bit low, warmer there. 40, look at that, low 20s, and that's why we're seeing some snow there. All right, here's a view of the satellite radar picture. Here's that front right now. Here's where the system is. It's going to work its way through across the area. But then as that exits, this is going to move in. This is a small area of high pressure that's going to make things dry and warm over the next few days. In fact, temperatures by the middle of the week will be back to average, which will be nice. But then we'll see another system roll in just in time for the Thanksgiving holiday, unfortunately. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at that seven-day forecast. Along the Orange County beaches, we're going to see that high build tomorrow. We'll see partly cloudy skies and then mostly clear Tuesday and Wednesday. Temperatures pretty close to average there, and then we'll see another system make its way in for Thanksgiving. Very short-lived. That's going to move out very and back to average, even in the valleys. 73 on Tuesday, 71 on Wednesday, and then we see that weak storm system make its way through, and then we start to see temperatures start to climb once again as we get around to Friday, 66 degrees, and then by the weekend, look at this, 74 on Saturday. And southbound side of the 405, as you approach the Wilshire exit, there is some flooding there. In fact, Wilshire is completely closed off, that off-ramp, because of that flooding, and they're expecting to reopen that probably by like maybe 9:30 this evening. Sig alert also continues for the westbound side of the 134 right around Orange Grove as you make your way out of Pasadena towards, the Eagle Rock area. A couple lanes are out of commission there. Luckily, though, at this hour, the volume is pretty light through that stretch. You're not going to find a big backup, thankfully. And then our last incident takes us to the Orange County area, southbound side of the 57 right around Chapman. That on-ramp as well as the right lane are going to be closed until further notice because of a car that flipped over. At this point, the wheels are still up in the air, and they're probably waiting for a tow truck. And again, that's going to be closed until further notice. They don't know how long it's going to take to clear that out. All right, that's a look at 5 Live Traffic and your 7-day forecast. Guys, back to you for now.